Hey everyone, I'm Pat Cupo, and I'd like to introduce you to Sculpt, Focus, and Tilt, three brand new EQs in Bitwig Studio 5.2. This trio of EQs are inspired by classic hardware and bring a natural musicality to the task of shaping sound. Sculpt inherited the controls and components of the renowned Pultec EQP-1, a broadband hardware box known for its low-end sweetening. On the left, we have controls for the low shelves, a low shelves frequency selector with four options, 20, 30, 60, and 100 Hz, a low boost amount, and a low cut amount. If you're new to this kind of EQ, I highly recommend that you try cutting and boosting something with some low end. It's kind of where the magic happens with this EQ. Next are the peak parameters. The peak boost frequency selector has seven options ranging from 3 kHz to 16 kHz. Below that is a peak boost amount, and there's the peak bandwidth. To the right of that, there are two high cut controls, a high cut frequency with three options. Note that the high cut can go lower than the peak boost. And there is a high cut amount. Below that is a visual display, which is very helpful for showing you exactly what you're doing. As a bonus, this display also shows up in the mixer, which is also viewable in the inspector. On the right, there are three color options where the choice of saturation is left up to you, from the matching tube style for warmth, to transistor with distinctive mid-range, or even a clinically clean mode. Finally, in the inspector, a stereoized control transforms any device into a pair so that you can emphasize the left versus right, or yes, mid versus side. In this example, I'm using Sculpt on a bass guitar track, and I have three goals. First, I need to tame the noisy pickups on my bass, and I'll use the high cut for that. Then, I didn't use my active pickups, and there's no bass boost coming from my guitar, so I'll use the bass boost and cut to dial in low end. Lastly, I want to emphasize the picked strings a bit. I'll use the peak boost and tube color option for some mid-range warmth. I like where this ended up. It kind of has a late 90s live drum and bass feel to it, and Sculpt definitely helped achieve that sound. Focus took the same approach to recreating the choices and components of the mid-range oriented MEQ-5. After tuning those sonic power regions, similar saturation choices are a click away. The controls are similar looking to Sculpt. There's a low-end boost amount, a mid-cut for a little dip, and a high boost amount, all with various options for frequency selection. And again, we see a visual display, the same color options, and the stereoized feature in the inspector. For this example, I'm playing guitar, and as you'll hear, there's a harsh mid-range tone, so I'll use Focus to fix it. Thank you. you can really hear and feel a difference in the tone of the guitar and the track as a whole. I don't know what else to say. It sounds more focused. Tilt's simple interface lets you rebalance any sound to be brighter or darker. At the top of Tilt, there's a gain that's in charge of the tilt of dual-shelf filters. Positive values amplify the upper band and attenuate the lower band by the same amount, and vice versa for negative frequencies. The frequency knob on the left sets the center frequency of the filters. The slope knob on the right morphs the relative slope of the filters, going from a gradual ramp towards an S-curve. And once again, there's a helpful visual display with the same color coding Bitwig users are used to, and the stereoize feature, which you'll see next. So the concept of tilt EQs is pretty self-explanatory, but what isn't straightforward is when you might want to use one. You could try using tilt before a distortion effect to quickly get lots of new tones from the pair. And you can get experimental and sound design context by automating tilt in weird and wonderful ways. In this example, I have a subtle use case, but it's super useful. I have something more hip-hop, more lo-fi, and I think I went a little too heavy on the bass frequencies in the mix. Tilt is handy in this scenario because it can attenuate the low end and lift the high end. And in these cases, you might only need a little tilt action. Just a few tiny changes made a big difference in the overall tone of the track, with a little help from the mid-side function, and we can see how a humble device like Tilt might play a major role in the mastering process. There you have it, folks, three welcome additions to a growing list of effects and devices. Go download version 5.2 today and try Sculpt, Focus, and Tilt for yourself. I'm really looking forward to seeing how you use it in your work. Once again, I'm Pat Cupo, and I'll see you next time. Bye now.